Everyone, my name is Ritesh Pandey, and in this class, this video, we'll take up a popular reaction mechanism, a very popular named reaction called Friedel-Crafts reaction, also abbreviated as FCR. We'll see it's one of the most popular electrophilic substitution reactions. Guess you know the most common organic reaction for aromatic hydrocarbons, including benzene, is electrophilic substitution. And I repeat, the most popular electrophilic substitution is Friedel-Crafts reaction. Now, what is this reaction all about? In general, for an aromatic ring, the common reaction is, say this is the benzene ring, which is attacked by an electrophile. And this is the result of electrophilic substitution. An electrophile will attach itself to the ring and H plus will come out of the benzene ring. Two things, lot of pi bonds here. So naturally pi bonds, being an easy, readily available source of electrons, will be attacked or will be inviting an electrophile. Electrophile is naturally electron loving species. So an electrophile will attack a ring, unsaturated aromatic ring, because there are so many pi bonds, freely available electrons. So it's prone to an electrophilic attack. An electrophile will attack because there are electrons. And unlike the aliphatic hydrocarbons, where you have an addition, you have a substitution here. E plus comes in, H plus goes. E plus comes in, H plus goes. Because in course of the substitution, see, we'll call it electrophilic substitution. We'll call it electrophilic substitution because in the substitution, when an electrophile comes in and H plus goes out, the structure is retained, aromaticity is retained. You would have been told that aromaticity is a lot of stability, so it will not give up its aromaticity. No pi bond will be lost. Electrophile aayega, H plus jayega, so that the aromatic structure is retained. So it's very logical for, you know, an aromatic hydrocarbon or aromatic compounds to undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. The most popular of this kind is Friedel-Crafts reaction, which is alkylation or acylation of the ring. So very formally, I can introduce FCR as a method of alkylation or acylation. Two primary types of the reaction, alkylation or acylation of the ring of aromatic compounds, generally using a Lewis acid. The most common example, or the frequently used Lewis acid, is AlCl3. A couple of reactions would look like a ring, aromatic ring, benzene, with RCl, say an alkyl halide with AlCl3. There will be an inert medium like nitrobenzene, and this will be the product. You'll have alkylated benzene. So this is an act of alkylation. H plus coming out of the ring will give you HCl with the Cl minus. So this will be a reaction of alkylation. And naturally, acyl chloride, AlCl3 will play the role of a catalyst. And this time, the ring will be acylated. This will be the general reaction. So this is an act of alkylation. This is an act of acylation. Alkylation or acylation of the ring using a Lewis acid as the catalyst. The process is called Friedel-Crafts reaction. We'll begin with the alkylation part. Naturally, a couple of examples could be methyl chloride giving you methyl benzene or toluene, ethyl chloride giving you ethyl benzene. You'll want to keep copying at your convenience. We'll talk of the mechanism very, very soon, but we'll begin with the alkylation part. I repeat, you'll want to keep copying at your convenience, and let's begin with the alkylation part. Now, alkylation is about incorporating or adding an alkyl group to the ring. In all of aromatic chemistry, you'd see most of the reactions are either about adding a group to the ring or removing a group from the ring. In this case, it's adding an alkyl group to the ring. So the most common reaction could be benzene plus CH3Cl Naturally, AlCl3 acting as the catalyst. You will get methyl benzene, you will get methyl benzene, popularly called toluene. And if it is CH3, CH2Cl, chloroethane, you will get ethyl benzene. You will get ethyl benzene. So these are a couple of very common examples. Both are cases of Friedel-Crafts alkylation, both are cases of Friedel-Crafts alkylation. And let's quickly look at the mechanism. Let's quickly look at the mechanism, which will be the mechanism of an electrophilic substitution. So once you're done copying this, what I'll do is, I'll write the general form of Friedel-Crafts reaction and we'll talk about its mechanism. So suppose the general reaction is written like a benzene ring with RCl, AlCl3. I repeat, we'll see it's going to play the role of a catalyst, giving you alkylated benzene plus HCl. It's all going to begin with generation of the electrophile. First of all, you'll have the generation of an electrophile. The electrophile will be generated, and AlCl3 with an incomplete octet. Certainly, in AlCl3, there are only three bonds. Aluminium with three chlorine atoms, octet is incomplete. You can write incomplete octet. So naturally, it will want to gain electrons and act as a Lewis acid. It will want to gain electrons, will act as a Lewis acid, and step one will be generation of electrophile. Now naturally, RCl plus AlCl3 acting as a Lewis acid, having incomplete octet, will want to gain Cl minus, and in the process generate R plus. This is the generation of electrophile. R plus is generated. The electrophile is generated. This electrophile in step two will attack the ring. So step two could be attack of the electrophile. It could be attack of the electrophile, in this case, an alkyl group. So you know about an electromeric effect. Naturally, this R plus, this will come here, and you'll have an intermediate like this. Now this intermediate will be stabilized by resonance. You can draw a resonating structure like this. This is something which you need to practice. Naturally, this pi bond can come here, and this could be the next intermediate. So these are the resonating structures of the intermediate. The resonating structures of the intermediate could be represented via a hybrid. So what I'll do is, positive, you have double bond character in all the three regions, and this is very popularly called a sigma complex. It's also called Wieland complex. So sigma complex or Wieland complex, which suppose an alkyl group here, and this will be step three. See, every time the intermediate is stabilized by resonance, you can conclude that the journey is going to be smoother. We always talk about the reactivity of a compound or the feasibility of a process in terms of the stability of the intermediate. Any day, if the intermediate is more stable, the compound is more reactive, the process is smoother, the journey is smoother. So naturally, when we look at the resonating structures of this sigma complex and end up drawing this resonance hybrid, it's all about ascertaining the feasibility of the process, the stability of the intermediate. And from any of these structures, or say the hybrid, this will be step three, which will be loss of H plus, completing the electrophilic substitution. It can be proved that hydrogen is lost from the same carbon which has got R plus. Now with this coming down, this positive will be neutralized. This will lose H plus. So when this loses H plus, you will get an alkylated benzene, and this H plus, this H plus, this H plus with AlCl4 minus, this H plus with AlCl4 minus, AlCl4 minus will regenerate naturally. H plus with AlCl3 minus would form HCl, the byproduct, and would regenerate AlCl3. So this is regenerated, this is regenerated. So I hope the three steps are clear to all of you. Step one is generation of the electrophile. AlCl3 will get the Cl minus drawn towards itself, generating an electrophile. This electrophile will attack the ring. This could be called an electromeric effect, the temporary effect, which is when a reagent, you know, comes into frame. So this electrophile will get attached to the ring. One electrophile will come. From the same carbon, H plus will go, completing the act of electrophilic substitution. That H plus will react with AlCl4 minus, regenerating AlCl3. So naturally, the role of AlCl3 is to generate the electrophile, to act as a Lewis acid, and certainly to behave as a catalyst. AlCl3 is the most popular Lewis acid acting as a catalyst in Friedel-Crafts reaction. Then everything which is with respect to the electrophilic substitution would be true for this reaction. We have seen in ortho-para meta-orientation in our classes on general organic chemistry. All the factors activating an aromatic ring, you know, plus I plus R effect, which we are ortho-para orienting in nature, plus I plus R effect, which will make the ring electron rich and thus more inviting for an electrophile, plus I plus R effect would kind of promote this process, minus I minus R effect would hinder the process. So the order of reactivity of various aromatic compounds would be the same, which is for any electrophilic substitution. You will want to maybe just very quickly go through those classes of general organic chemistry where we talk about the reactivity of various aromatic compounds. Plus I plus R effect, I'll note down somewhere, plus I plus R effect would promote the process. Naturally, minus I minus R effect would hinder the process, and a very less reactive minus I minus R effect containing nitrobenzene could act as a solvent in the process. These are the three primary steps. Generation of electrophile, attack of the electrophile, and then this losing H plus. It's recommended that you recall the name of the complex, which is called a sigma complex. Now, you're able to bring methyl into the ring, you're able to bring ethyl into the ring. The problem would be when you want to bring a normal propyl ring into the ring. So once we know a little bit about the mechanism, we can talk a little bit about the limitations of the process. What are the limitations of the process? So once you have copied all of this, the next subheading would be limitations of FCR. And when it comes to the limitations of FCR, when it comes to the limitations of the process, the first limitation is when we try to produce N-propyl benzene. So the first limitation of FCR is encountered when you try to prepare N-propyl benzene, CH3CH2CH2Cl, with AlCl3. Now this is what is expected, N-propyl benzene, this is expected, but this would be the major product. The major product would be isopropyl benzene. This would be the major product. Which is isopropyl benzene. It has a very common name. It's called cumene. You want to prepare N-propyl benzene, you get isopropyl benzene or cumene as the major product. I'll quote this as the first limitation of FCR, which is the introduction of long chain normal alkyl groups. That's expected, because right away when AlCl3 will get the Cl minus and thereby generating this electrophile, which is CH3CH2CH2 plus, It's not a very stable carbocation. It's a 1 degree carbocation. It's a 1 degree carbocation. And naturally, everything relevant to carbocation will be experienced here. You know, every time you have a carbocation involved in the process, you have molecular rearrangements, hydride methyl shift. So this will undergo a 1-2 hydride shift. This will undergo a 1-2 hydride shift. This will undergo a 1-2 hydride shift. Naturally, it will become a more stable 2-degree carbocation. And if this is the more stable 2-degree carbocation, attacking the ring, the final structure would bear an isopropyl group. The final structure will bear the isopropyl group. This might be a minor product. This will be a major product. And this is how we come across the first limitation of FCR. I think it's understood by everyone that this will be a challenge introducing long chain normal alkyl groups, because certainly a 1 degree carbocation or a less branched carbocation, that's the nature of carbocation, will get rearranged via one or the other molecular rearrangement. In this case, a hydride shift. You know, 2 degree carbocation is more stable than 1 degree carbocation. So you'll have some molecular rearrangement every time, you know, a carbocation is formed, and that will be a problem. Like you can't get N-propyl benzene right away using 1-chloropropane. We'll come to the remedy, but there will be a lot of such cases. There will be a lot of such cases. In the sense. We're all through the various kind of molecular rearrangements, be it hydride shift or methyl shift. So I can certainly think about a reaction like this, where, you know, if you make this particularly neopentyl chloride react with AlCl3, This will be the initial carbocation, which will be a 1 degree carbocation. CCl- will get, AlCl3 will take Cl-, you'll get this as the initial carbocation. But we know that this 1 degree is not very stable, and right away you'll have a 1-2 methyl shift. And if you have a 1-2 methyl shift, if this methyl group goes here, you get a more stable carbocation, which is a 3-degree carbocation, And if this is a more stable carbocation, generated by a 1-2 methyl shift, expect this to be the eventual electrophile. So it's all in accordance with the nature of carbocation. Nothing new. Remember the first time I tell you about a hydride or methyl shift. You know, I do tell you that every time you have a carbocation formed in the medium, every time you have carbocation acting as an intermediate, you'll have molecular rearrangements. So it's a one-time effort. You know, you learn molecular rearrangements, and this being more stable, this will go to the ring, and this is what we do. Simple. We attach this particular group and expect this to be the major product. So this is beyond control. Until we are able to change the mechanism, until we do it in some other manner, you'll have molecular rearrangements. This is one limitation of FCR. Another limitation is, you know about hyperconjugation. You know about plus I effect of an alkyl group. So certainly. Even in case of a very simple Friedel-Crafts, you know, which is benzene to toluene, and this is absolutely allowed. This is the most common way of preparing toluene from benzene. This is the most popular way of preparing toluene from benzene. It's absolutely allowed. School exams, board exams, everywhere, this Friedel-Crafts is allowed. But a genuine thought is, this methyl group with its plus I effect and hyperconjugation is more reactive than benzene. And if it's more reactive than benzene, under the conditions you are carrying out Friedel-Crafts over benzene, you know, when you are carrying out a Friedel-Crafts over benzene, Toluene, which is more reactive, will certainly undergo Friedel-Crafts. So this is difficult to stop. This is difficult to stop. Another step of fetal graft over this toluene, which is ortho para orienting. And this will be the product. This will be the product. You will get a pair of ortho and para xylene. You will get a pair of ortho and para xylene. And now xylene with two methyl groups, will be even more reactive. With more plus I, more hyperconjugation, xylene is even more reactive than toluene. So under these conditions, they are more prone to, you know, further FCR, and this will lead to what's called polyalkylation. This will lead to polyalkylation until and unless you are able to control the process, that is, until and unless, you know, by some way you control the amount of CH3Cl, you keep it 1:1 ratio, or even under such conditions, you cannot guarantee that this will be the major product. You know, this will be the only product, because this being more reactive than benzene will certainly undergo FCR to form xylene, which will be even more reactive than toluene, and polyalkylation is another problem, considering, you remember, that plus I effect, hyperconjugation makes the ring even more electron rich and more reactive. You know, plus I effect, plus R effect, hyperconjugation, you know, this is a more activated ring. With two methyl groups, it's even more activated. So polyalkylation is another problem in normal alkylation. And as a remedy of these two issues, as a remedy of these two limitations, we come across acylation. We'll see the mechanism of acylation, but we'll also see that acylation would be like a very simple remedy to both these problems, where with acylation, almost everything remaining the same, the electrophile will be different. Almost everything remaining the same, the electrophile will be different. Instead of alkyl group, the electrophile will be acyl group. And before I talk of acylation, I'll take this opportunity to write the three steps one more time. So in acylation, it will be RCOCl, AlCl3 getting hold of the Cl minus. And this is the effective electrophile. Now this electrophile, acyl carbocation, it doesn't rearrange. So naturally, when it doesn't rearrange, you can control the process. RCO plus attacking the ring, electrobaric effect again, RCO plus attacking the ring would give you like alkylation. You know, this would be the corresponding sigma complex. I'll write the name again. This will be the corresponding sigma complex or Wieland complex. This will be the corresponding sigma complex or Wieland complex, and this will get rid of H plus from the same carbon. This H plus will go. Step number 3. You know, making the ring neutral again, and now this is the final product. This H plus would regenerate AlCl, because, you know, this would have become AlCl4 minus, this would have become AlCl4 minus, and this H plus, you know, coming out of the ring would give you HCl as the byproduct, and AlCl3 would be regenerated. It's playing the role of a catalyst. Now, the only difference is, and a prime difference is, this time the electrophile is an acyl group. You call it acylation because the electrophile is an acyl group, which will not rearrange. So let's look at the application front. You'll want to maybe one time more copy the mechanism. The more number of times you copy the mechanism, the more number of times you kind of draw these arrows, you write this positive charges, you know, break these bonds, you know, the more equipped, skilled you are, you know, working with the mechanism of various reactions, this being a very popular mechanism. And now, how does it help? How does acylation help? It will help. How does acylation help? You'll want to follow very carefully. This time, what I'll do is, how acylation would be a remedy to both the limitations. This time, I would make benzene ring react with the corresponding acyl chloride, naturally in presence of AlCl3. So everything remaining the same, Cl minus taken by AlCl3. And the electrophile will be CH3CH2 C double bond O plus, which will go to the ring. So this will not rearrange, unlike the acyl carbocation, where a 1 degree was getting rearranged by hydride shift to a more stable carbocation. This time the electrophile, I repeat, the electrophile would not rearrange. There will be no molecular rearrangement. So you will be able to have a linear attachment of 3 carbon atoms, and this to this, you know, we were basically willing to get N-propylbenzene. Will not be a big deal, because we know how to convert a ketone to an alkane, either Clemmensen reduction or Wolff-Kistner reduction. Two very popular methods, Clemmensen reduction or Wolff-Kistner method. Maybe for the time being, I'm using amalgamated zinc and HCl to reduce this ketonic compound to this particular hydrocarbon, which is N-propylbenzene, and the first problem is taken care of. Now very easily I can convert benzene to N-propylbenzene, or to whatever length of N-alkyl chain I want to attach to the ring, because instead of alkylation I'll be carrying out acylation, knowing that the corresponding intermediate will not rearrange. So you will not get any kind of branching here, you will not get any kind of rearranged product here, and you will be able to attach a alkyl group, normal alkyl group of whatever length you want, carrying out acylation. So the first problem is taken care of, the first limitation is taken care of. The second limitation was of polyalkylation. Now the second limitation is also not a situation here. Recall, you know, this is basically a meta-orienting group. This has a minus R. An acyl group has a minus R effect. It's a deactivating group. Very quickly, if you go through the stuff which I gave you in orthopara meta orientation, you will remember that this is a compound having a minus R effect. With a minus R effect, deactivating nature, this is less reactive than benzene. And if this is less reactive than benzene, there will be no polyacylation. Ek bar ye group chala gaya, it kind of deactivates the ring. This is less reactive than benzene, and once it's deactivated, it doesn't invite more electrophile. On the other hand, alkylated benzene being more reactive was kind of inciting polyalkylation. This is less reactive than benzene. Ek group ghus gaya, dusra group dalna will be difficult. So there is no polyacylation. There is no polyacylation like polyalkylation. This is hardly the beginning. We're going to see a lot of applications of this process. Chances are, I'm going to talk about a few right now. And certainly, with time, our understanding of the mechanism is bound to grow. This is the first hand experience or encounter of this mechanism for the first time. Naturally, with more cases seen, with some complicated examples seen, our understanding is going to be reviewed, there are going to be more layers of understanding. The mechanism is going to be more thoroughly viewed, observed. Like I tell you that it's the sigma complex which we begin with, but a very popular theory says that there is a pi complex preceding the sigma complex. AlCl3 might be the most popular reagent as a catalyst, but AlBr3, FeCl3, ZnCl2, can act, also act as the corresponding catalyst, can also act as the corresponding basis. ALCl3 is the most popular, but ALBr3, FeCl3, ZnCl2, and there are more compounds which kind of have incomplete octet and can act as the Lewis bases and the catalysts in this process. Nitrobenzene is a very popular solvent for the process because nitrobenzene is very less reactive. So nitrobenzene is a very popular reagent, a very popular solvent. This is very less reactive. Naturally, it's very less reactive. NO2 will have very strong minus I, minus R effect. So minus I, minus R effect will render it very less reactive. So many times you see no rearrangement happening, you know, with FeCl3, if you find no rearrangement as happening, you know, some cases like you have FeCl3 instead of ALCl3, FeCl3 instead of ALCl3, and you see no rearrangement, you know, this would be the major product. This would be the major product. You would see this time, you know, you are able to bring an alkyl propane and propyl benzene. There is no rearrangement product. This is the major compound. This is the major compound. So certainly this will happen. This will happen when the carbocation is not completely formed. This will happen when the carbocation is not completely formed. And a very common theory this time is FeCl3 kind of starts attracting the Cl minus, but the chlorine is not completely detached. The chlorine is not completely detached. In the sense, you have an arrangement like this. You have an arrangement like this. Where this chlorine is kind of attracted by iron. There is some positive charge here. There is some positive charge here. Naturally, this positive charge is attacking the ring. This positive charge is attacking the ring. But it's more like a polarized complex. 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 Where this carbocation is not completely formed, and when the carbocation is not completely formed with some catalyst, you know, there might not be rearrangement. It's a weaker association. It's a weaker association between the ring and the alkyl group. So a weaker association is represented or is stated as a pi complex. I told you pi and sigma eventually are two symbolic terms. A stronger association is called a sigma association. A weaker association is called a pi association. But everything which I told you about molecular rearrangements involving ALCl3, considering a carbocation and a sigma complex is how the process moves, is more normal general chemistry. You know, taking care of all the exams and the questions you're going to experience. But there will be a few cases where, you know, there will be some fine tuning in the mechanism, and certainly a pi complex is going to precede a sigma complex. With more examples, more learning awaits. Lot of applications of this process, and a couple of informations I need to tell you. A couple of strange facts. Normally, the reverse is the order of reactivity. Normally, it's the iodide more reactive than bromide, more reactive than chloride, than fluoride. Now, this will be the order of reactivity. This will be the order of reactivity. This will be the order of reactivity of alkyl halides towards alkylation. And the normal would be, which is the expected one for acylation. So these are two anomalies which you want to know. This is like more normal. This is my like more normal. Iodide more reactive than bromide, more reactive than chloride when it comes to acylation. Now this is a little different. This is a little different, largely because the breakage of this bond is not the redetermining step. The breakage of this bond is not the redetermining step. So unlike the normal case where iodide is more reactive than bromide, which is more reactive than chloride, you have a different order altogether for alkylation, but an expected order for acylation. I think it will make more sense to talk about the applications once I give you some problems, some assignments to solve in FCR. I would kind of stop here And in the next video, where we talk about the problems, the questions on FCR, the application part would be worth, you know, talking of. So this much for the time being. Wait for questions and assignments on this topic, and see you in the next class. Thank you so much.